How to use GSmart Ledger technology to analyze customer payment patterns and automatically improve cash flow forecast accuracy by 30%.
Another area where we can start bringing artificial intelligence into play. So I'm just going to jump into my AR. So exactly the same process I'm about to describe happens on the payable side, but I'm going to focus more on the receivable side for now. And I'm just going to just jump into this invoice for AT&T. So what we can see, this particular invoice was due on the 25th, sorry, was issued on the 25th of December, had 60-day payment terms. It was due on the 23rd of Feb. But what we can see that actually the system has put this invoice on the 10th of March. So it's actually pushed it out a few weeks. The system has done that for me automatically. Why has it done that? Because it's based on the artificial intelligence, the statistical analysis that the system is doing for me as we're pulling in accounts payable and accounts receivable information. So I'm just going to jump into the smart ledger so we can see that in a bit more detail. So first of all, of course, we're pulling in all of your open invoices. So these are the invoices that the system is then going to use to actually populate your forecast. But we're also pulling in the closed ledger, the history of how your customers have paid you and how you're paying your vendors. The system analyzes that history and starts to build up profiles for all of your customers and all of your vendors. So if we just jump into, again, we're looking at the receivable side of things here. If we look into our customer profiles, and again, we focus in on AT&T, what we saw on that invoice we just looked at is that AT&T have 60-day payment terms. However, what the system has recognized through the analysis it's doing of all of the payment history is that actually on average, AT&T pay on day 75. So what that tells us is for any open invoices we have, there's very little, if any point, putting them on the due date because AT&T always pay 15 days late. And that is what the system is doing for me automatically. The default model, if you like, that the system uses is what we call the historic average. So instead of putting an open invoice for AT&T on day 60, it's gonna put it on day 75. Now, there are different models you can use to influence how the system is going to treat each individual customer, and then further refinements you can make to the process, to the profile over here on the right-hand side. But by default, the system, as I said, is going to be analyzing payment history and using that behavior to influence how and when it puts open invoices into your forecast. So this is really going to help drive accuracy in your forecasting. And what we've learned is that across all the systems that are using this smart ledger functionality, we're seeing at least a 30% increase in accuracy of accounts payable and accounts receivable forecasted flows. So really powerful, really successful at doing what we want it to do.